Hey everyone, welcome back to another Tic Tac Tyco. You know what? I've been holding back, and this week I'm gonna unleash some difficult drills on you. How difficult? Well, you're gonna have to stick around and find out. I try to consider my audience when I make videos. For example, I know some of you don't play taiko, so I try to make my videos informative. I know some of you haven't played taiko for very long, so I try to cover a wide range of topics. And I know there are some of you who don't have access to a lot of taiko or very often, so I try to show you how you don't need to have taiko to get better at taiko. I'm also sure that some of you are finding my drills to be a bit on the easy side. Maybe not all of them, but enough. So this week, I dedicated the video to you, and the drills are going to be difficult. If you don't think you're in that caliber of performer yet, don't worry. There are 4 drills this week of increasing difficulty, and you don't know which ones you can or can't do until you actually try them. Just a couple of things before I get into the actual drill. First, you don't need any equipment for the drill, although you might find that a metronome comes in handy. Next, you don't have to worry about where the one is when you're doing a solo. Usually for these type of drills, you want to make sure you know where you are on the 8 count or 6 count or whatever. Not so much for this. More importantly, you want to stay on tempo, which is where the metronome comes in handy. And finally, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. And I'm doing this early because I feel like I might be losing some of you as we get more and more difficult. The first of the 4 drills is one of my favorites. You're gonna play a solo, either with bachi or using your hands, doesn't matter. But whatever you play, you have to simultaneously say using kuchishoga. Another way to think of this is you're going to vocalize your solo using kuchishoga. And whatever you say, you have to simultaneously play. It's the same drill either way, but it might feel slightly different depending on how you approach it. Boom, 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 boom. Our second drill has you playing a G, repetitive short pattern, maybe don doko, dorotsuku, dongo, whatever. While you're playing that pattern, you're going to vocalize a solo. So your hands and your voice are doing different things now. In drill number 3, we're going to switch what was doing what. So now I'm going to vocalize a G, any G, doesn't have to be the one I did in drill number 2, and I'm going to play my solo. Dorotsuku, 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 I'm going to apologize in advance for drill number 4 because it's something no one should ask you to do, and yet I'm asking you to do it. You're going to play 2 solos, one with your hands and one with your voice. at the same time, and they're going to be two completely different solos. Let that sink in. Yeah. Yeah. But before you jump into the deep end and try this and realize that it's not water, it's lava, I'm going to give you two sort of warm-up versions, ways to get into this drill that make doing the actual drill a little bit easier. The first thing you can do is only use one hand to play. This will keep you from playing too many notes and getting out of hand. It forces you to be more sparse, which lets you process more of what you're vocalizing, so it's a little easier to get into. Don, 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 suku, doro, suku, doro, suku, doro, suku, suku, don, suku, doro, ka, ka, doro, ka, ka, doro, ka, don, ka, do, don, ka, do, 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 go, do, don, don, ka, don, ka, don, ka, don, ka, don, don, ka, 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 don, don, do, go, 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 don, do, don, 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 don. The second thing to do is to do the drill, but slowly and sparsely. Don't play a lot of notes. Don't say a lot of notes. Just take it easy, baby steps, because again, that lava pool is going to hurt if you jump into it full speed. Doro tsuku, doro tsuku, don. Don, 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 don. Don, ka, ka, doro, don. Don, don, don. Doro, don, 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 ka, ka, don, 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 ka, ka, don, 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 doro, don, 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 ka, ka, don, 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 ka, don, don, doro, ka, 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 don, don. And finally, the full drill. Wish me luck. Ka, don, 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 ba, don. I'm going to be real honest here. It took me several tries before I had a run that I felt comfortable enough to broadcast. Don't watch this video and think, oh, well, Adam could do it just like that. It's super easy. It's not super easy. I have the benefit of video editing to pick the one that looks good, but there's plenty of struggle and plenty of times where it just did not work out. Hey, if you've made it this far, congratulations, because honestly, I don't think everybody hung on as long as you did. But you may be asking yourself, why on earth would you make me do these horrible, painful drills? When you solo and you make a mistake, you don't want to stop. And you also don't want to make facial expressions that show the audience that you made a mistake. But they both happen. We're only human. It's hard to find a drill that lets you practice how to handle making mistakes. Because if you're making a mistake on purpose, it's not really a mistake, is it? Another thing these drills do is help teach interdependence, separating your brain from your hands or your body. When you can pull back some processing power and let your hands do more on their own, not 100% necessarily, you have more opportunity to be creative, to add movement, to have more performance, more connection. It's just easier. I use the analogy a lot of having a baseball player swinging three bats to warm up and then just having one. This drill is the equivalent of learning how to swing three bats, because when you get to a regular solo where you only have one thing to worry about, it's gonna be so much more easy after a drill like this. Ultimately, these drills work on advanced concepts. Whether or not you found some or all of the drills actually difficult or not, you're definitely working on things that most drills don't touch. All right, I hope I didn't alienate any of you this week. And if you're one of those people who was able to do the fourth drill easily, my metaphorical hat is off to you, and let me know because I want to take lessons from you. So until next time, keep on practicing and be well.